Hello, Frugal Force. This is Captain Frugal reporting for duty. If you remember recently, I did a review and a discussion about these Marvel superhero adventure game books and how cool they were to do. Now I'm going to up it even one more and show you something even more cool. This is something you can do with two players. They come in like this. It's Marvel Superheroes one-on-one adventure game books. This one is DareDevil vs. the Kingpin by James M. Ward. Okay, and the two books come in there, they slide in there and you just pull them out and you get two game books with that. This was by TSR, through TSR, for $5.95 you'd get two books. And it says, the Big Apple has a rotten core. Midnight in the city of New York, it's raining. 3 miles away from each other, two men make exactly the same decision at exactly the same time. One is Daredevil, the red costume fighter for justice who uses his uncanny senses to fight evil where he finds it. The other is Kingpin, the pinstripe-clad warrior who has followed his own code of ethics while fighting and clawing his way to the top of a criminal empire more powerful than many small nations. Each has decided to eliminate the other in a duel to the death on the streets of New York. Inside are two books for two players. One of you becomes Daredevil, and the other becomes Kingpin. Everything you need to play is provided. Two books, combat table, and character sheets. No dice are required. All you need is a heavy supply of luck and two pencils. Play anytime, anywhere, many times. And this is The King Takes a Dare. It was, Yep, 1987 was when this was printed. Okay, and what it is you get these two books. Okay, one picks out Daredevil and one plays as Kingpin. And each one is going to give you a different story and different goals. So it tells you the story of what's going to happen with that character. And then it has rules. It's going to give you all the rules. It's sort of like you get health, karma, things like that. And you're going to get goals. For each character has goals and it'll guide you through those goals. And if Kingpin accomplishes his goals, he wins. Daredevil's goal, of course, he has several goals too. It's not just to beat up the Kingpin. So you'd go to his, and his would give you his reading, and it'd tell you his goals. Like phase one, deplete Kingpin's income. Phase two, make a direct assault on Kingpin's image. Phase three is you would attack the Kingpin. So that was his goal. So for example, his differences there from the Kingpin is here. Phase one, direct attacks. And phase two, public scorn campaign. And phase three, personal combat. And you'd go through these phases and you'd read your section. And depending on the choices you'd make, it'd put you in different situations. In those situations, you might have to fight some bad guys, do something to escape a situation. It's got pretty cool art in it too. And so it's like a choose your own adventure, but like we did with the Thing one, you have some additional things. You have health and things in combat. Now, it does say that how you do combat is each person would pick out a number 1 through 20. And you'd line it up to paste on the defender and the attacker on the table and it'd show what happened. I tend to think if you do that long enough, you're going to know what certain numbers were. So if you do have a 20-sided die or two, each one would roll that 20-sided die. And then you could correlate those numbers. It doesn't say that in instructions, but I found that it'd be a better way yet to play it. Because let's be honest, if after you know a few numbers, if they call out a number, you could call out a number knowing what it was going to be if you have really good memory. But if you don't, you know, you don't have to worry about it. But if you do, I think dice make it more random and makes it a little bit more fun. So ultimately, Daredevil has to stop Kingpin, and Kingpin tries to stop Daredevil. And based on what the results are, you know,
you would get different outcomes. As you see, there's Black Widow in this book, Taskmaster. The art was pretty good in these books, too, so they give you some good visuals to look at. The back of each book would give you the information about the characters, your character, as well as all these characters here that you could potentially get into battles with. It give you their hit points and things like that, so when you battled them, you would, you know, check that off. Sort of, I guess, like a role-playing game. A lot of them have things like this. Probably much more simple than that, of course. But, I mean, look at all these characters you could do battle with and things like that. Captain America was in this book and lots of other cool characters and things. I mean, look at this. It's really cool. You'd read it like a Choose Your Own Adventure. There's Dazzler. See, even she was in that book. See, artwork's good. A lot of fun to read. Two players play against each other. You could play it time and time again. Maybe the first time you play it, you're playing as Daredevil, and the other person's playing as Kingpin. Then you could switch it up, and next game you play, the other one could play as Kingpin, and the other play as Daredevil. So you could play this game time and time again. All right, well, I hope you enjoyed this, because I truly enjoyed this. These books are a lot of fun. If you see other books like this, you know, definitely let me know. See, you know, tell me if you have any in the comments. Also, you can find these at, you know, garage sales, used bookstores. You should be able to get them pretty cheap. They're definitely, in my opinion, worth it and a lot of fun. All right, if you enjoyed this video, please be sure to hit like and subscribe. Hit that info bar down below. Look at, there's a link for a Patreon. I would strongly suggest that if you don't mind, you could contribute just $1 a month. We'd greatly appreciate it. And that would also help you to get notifications, because I've had people tell me, even though they're subscribed and hit the notifications bell, they're still not receiving any notifications for the videos. And for that, I apologize. But if you're on the Patreon, I also put the notifications on Patreon, so it should pop up and you should get it. Also, that would put you in a drawing, because once in a while we do things, like we're going to do a, very soon, we're doing a drawing. Little Frugal and I are going to the comic shop to get Action Comics 1000 and some other things. And we're also going to pick up something for a random Patreon drawing as a prize. So until next time, keep it frugal.